All right, so chapter 13, Equilibrium. We started talking about this last year. I should have a kind of basic understanding of what's going on here already, but we're going to get into a lot more depth this year. So let's just start out with what we did last year. This is on page 579. Equilibrium is the direct result of rate. So we just got done with our rate laws, right? And we had the two different types, but they were telling us how fast a reaction, and remember RxN is reaction, is going. Okay, well, equilibrium that is a U. So, and I didn't even look at how to spell that. Equilibrium is telling us where the reaction is going. What concentrations are we reaching? Remember, this is concentrations. So my rate tells me how fast my equilibrium is achieved. So they are very much related. They look alike. They have a lot of similar attributes to them. So make sure that you understand they are related, but they are not the same thing. All right? What we're talking about with equilibrium is book gives us this. Table is figures on page 580. If I take H2O and CO and carbon monoxide and I put them in a container, I will make hydrogen and carbon dioxide. Okay? What we're doing with equilibrium is we're saying, okay, where are these two going to go to? How much are they going to make? And then, and this is the key part that we don't talk about a lot in chemistry until we get to the spot that you guys are at now. Once this happens, these two are going to start mixing and make those again. Okay? So we have a forward reaction and a reverse reaction. If I draw this out, what I'm going to see is I'm going to start up here with my H2O. And my CO, I start with the same amount. They're going to start reacting, and there's going to get less and less and less and less and less of them until, in theory, it would go all the way away. Well, my amount of H2 and CO and CO2 is going to get more and more and more and more and more. And so what we would expect to see is something like this, that all of my reactants go away and form all of my products. Oops, I hit the wrong button there. Form all of my products. Okay, what we actually see because of this reverse reaction is, and so I'm going to change my colors here, my reactants are going to start, they're going to go, and they're going to get to a certain point, and then they're going to level out, so that's a flat line. Okay, my products are going to increase until they get to a certain point, and then they're going to start remaking my reactants. And so instead of going all the way up to here and all the way down to here, we stop before that at this point in time, okay, and we get this flat line and we say, it's not that the amount that the H2O that I have there and the CO have stopped reacting. They keep reacting. They keep on making H2 and CO2. It's not that the H2 and CO2 have stopped reacting. They keep on reacting and making H2O and CO. But they're doing it at a rate that makes it so that it never looks like it's changing. So if we have like a stadium with all the people sitting in it, and we have some people leaving and some people going in, it's not that the same people are there, but the amount of people don't change in the stadium, right? That would be an example of equilibrium. Okay, so it is not that it has stopped. Don't think that it has stopped reacting. It's just those are the levels that everything is consistent at. It's going forward, it's going back, and it looks like nothing is changing. Okay, So if we graph it differently, so that first one we were graphing concentration versus time. The second one, what we would see is my forward rate of reaction going like this. So we're going to, and my reverse rate of reaction looks like this. And they would hit each other and be equal. This is the equilibrium spot. My forward reaction versus my equals rate of reaction is equal to my reverse. Rate of reaction. All right, so this is if it is my reaction rates that are being graphed, that they will go to the exact same. This is if it is my concentrations, and they are not the same concentration. They can be, but usually they are not. Notice that the lines do not match up. The concentrations are usually different. The reaction rates are the same at equilibrium, the concentrations are not. All right? This can happen it always happens. It can be prevented or it can be changed by a number of different things. And we will talk more about those things later.